Rajdeep Sardesai spoke to JNU-SU President Aishe Ghosh on the JNU violence. Listen into a slice of that conversation.
Did you damage the power supplies, break the optical fibers, make the servers dysfunctional? That is the accusation. The accusation of the JNU administration is
nothing of that sort has happened. It is complete malafide lies that the JNU administration is spreading. There are no videos as proof that the left or the JNU Students Union has done anything of that sort. Neither the JNU Students Union have resorted to any kind of violence. I'm saying this being in the forefront that we have never resorted to any kind of violence. And I'm saying this that we have always been democratic. We have been asking the Vice Chancellor from the past 70 days that we want to have a dialogue. And we exactly had a dialogue even with the MHRD. Then why is the Vice Chancellor shying away from having a dialogue at this present moment to end this crisis which is happening in the campus from the past 70 days? And I want to clearly ask, does that whatever protest is happening from the past 70 days, does that mean that the Vice Chancellor will allow unmasked goons with iron rods unleashing violence in the campus? What audacity that the Vice Chancellor of a university has that he will ensure that no protection is given to students? The Delhi police was informed by me personally over the WhatsApp that there is tense situation happening in the campus, and I want the Delhi police to be aware of this. Why didn't the police take action or intervene when they knew about this scenario? I just want to ask, why did the Vice Chancellor not take immediate and urgent step to handle such situations? Why didn't the internal security, the cyclops, handle the situation properly?
Since 6:30 p.m. last Sunday, there have been 5 videos shot by JNU students that are now trending on social media. Videos that may possibly piece together what went down that day. Here's a look. These visuals that are playing across your screens at the moment show clashes between the left and the ABVP students. This happened much before the mass mob targeted the students. ABVP released this particular video claiming the girl in the video is JNU-SU student Aishe Ghosh. The ABVP has claimed that she led the mass mob that wreaked havoc in the university. Now here's the next video. At 6:30 p.m. on Sunday, armed mob went on a rampage inside the university, targeting students and resorting to vandalism. They're armed with sticks and rods and other sharp-edged weapons. And at 7 p.m. on Sunday, these visuals of Aishe Ghosh, the president of the JNU-SU, sent shockwaves. She was targeted by the mob and left critically injured. These visuals now across your screens have raised eyebrows on the role of Delhi cops as well. On your screens at the moment, you can see armed attackers leaving the JNU campus, but the cops neither intercepted nor arrested them. They were completely let off. Milan, obviously the probe and the Delhi police probe at the moment would have taken into consideration all these videos that were shot by the students that have gone viral on social media, on WhatsApp as well. And there's just a lot of rumor mongering that you can see even on social media with regards to these videos that we've just played out. What has been the Delhi police's probe and the revelation that they have made in regard to this particular video?
Well, there have been, as you mentioned, a lot of videos that had started trickling in right after the scuffle broke out inside the campus. And, you know, the police sources have told us, because the PCR call was made from inside the campus at around 5 p.m. That is exactly when the police was able to ascertain that something is wrong inside, because, as you remember, that the administration had, you know, filed a complaint against students because the registration process was hampered. And between that, you know, the left students as well as the ABBP students were involved in that scuffle. There were WhatsApp groups that have ascertained that the attacks were being planned perpetratedly, because there were messages that were being shown. We have seen a lot of pictures that have come out with students holding fiber batons, lathis and sticks. So certainly there are questions that are being raised on the police administration as well as the security inside the JNU as to how these students were allowed to take armed weapons. We have seen viral videos from inside the girls' hostel near Periyar where the vandalism took place. And there have been videos where Aishe Ghosh had also come out and said that she was attacked and mercilessly beaten. She had her skull broken there, and which is why the police is investigating all these angles right now. What we know for sure that the students that were taken to AIIMS who were injured, there were 34 in number. There were also professors from inside the campus who were injured in this scuffle when it broke out. And certainly the police is relying on CCTV footages, WhatsApp messages, as well as viral videos to identify who were these people, especially when you speak about the masked people who were involved in the entire scuffle. They are also currently being identified by the police, and the crime branch continues its investigation. We have not seen any arrest made in this particular matter, but probably later by the day we will see a few arrests that the police could
Absolutely.
Have made in the
Milan,
case after
you are at JNU at the moment, and we're also playing out those live visuals that are flashing across the screens at the moment. If you could walk our viewers through what is going on outside the JNU, we can see heavy police deployment from the live visuals that are coming in. Over to you.
Well, yes, certainly. You know, right now also outside the JNU, police deployment is heavy. Let me just, you know, ask my camera person Pradeep Gupta to pan and show you. Throughout, we are looking at the police deployment that has gone right on till the roads. Yeah, yesterday there were barricades erected on the roads because, you know, at any point of time, there were students who were coming out in protests on the streets. And right now also, we are looking at the road jam-packed here because now, as the day begins, the police presence has been increased. The gate is currently shut, and at the gate also, I can show you there is police standing here, because at this point also, Chaiti, when you enter JNU, you have to go through security checks and barriers, but now they have been increased because of the current scuffle that broke out inside and because the police investigation is currently underway.
Okay, leave it at that. Milan Sharma getting us up to speed with the latest developments as far as JNU is concerned. As expected, the violence in the JNU campus has kicked off a political whodunit with the opposition training its guns at the government. The BJP has responded to the charge accusing left groups of inciting the violence. Here's a report with all the whole host of political reactions that have been coming in on this story.
The nation has been stunned by these images of vandalism, violence and clashes in the Jawaharlal Nehru University. And the university, which isn't new to controversies, is now in the midst of an intense political battle. Parties are now trading charges over who is to blame for the violence in the JNU campus. From comments drawing a parallel to 2611,
ये जो हमलावर थे क्या जरूरत थी उनको नकाब पहनने की ये तो कायर थे कायर है और ऐसी कायरता का कभी भी अपने हिंदुस्तान में समर्थन नहीं हो सकता तो ये तो मुझे 26 नवंबर का जो हमला हुआ था उसकी याद आ गई
टू हिटलर जाइब्स एट द मोदी गवर्नमेंट
हिटलर की नाजी जर्मनी की याद 90 साल के बाद दोबारा नरेंद्र मोदी जी और अमित शाह जी ने पूरे देश के युवाओं और छात्रों पर दमन चक्कर चलाकर याद दिला दी
द ऑपोजिशन इज स्पिनिंग द ब्लेम ऑन द सेंटर बट द बीजेपी हैज स्लैम्ड लेफ्ट ग्रुप्स
जानबूझ के देश में हिंसा का माहौल पैदा करने की कुछ लोगों की कोशिश है
दिस इज एन ऑर्गेनाइज्ड प्रीप्लान्ड अटैक फ्रॉम आउटसाइडर्स Who they are was very clear from the slogans they were shouting.
The opposition is putting up a united face against the government.
I will appeal all the students' community, be together, fight together. Let us fight the battle together against of this government.
There is no doubt that these people had been given a green signal by the powers be.
Bharatiya Janata Party jaanti hai. कि पॉलिटिकल प्रोपोगेंडा कहां से फैलाया जा सकता है
बट द गवर्नमेंट इज अग्रेसिवली काउंटरिंग द पॉलिटिकल फायर दे आर फेसिंग ओवर द कैंपस वायलेंस
ये शिक्षण संस्थाओं में शिक्षा का काम होना चाहिए ये मैंने पहले भी कहा है, किसी भी शिक्षण संस्था को राजनीति का अड्डा बनने नहीं दिया जाएगा।
As questions loom over who resorted to violence in the JNU campus, political parties are now resorting to one-upmanship in the run-up to the Delhi elections. Bureau Report, India Today.
Manish Pandey is joining us live from JNU now. Good morning, Manish. What are we picking up as far as the Sunday violence is concerned at the JNU? There's been a police probe. One thing can be established is there was a presence of outsiders, and whether or not this was a premeditated attack or not. Over to you, Manish, on the findings.
Yeah, well, Chaiti, as far as the investigation is concerned, two things are clear now. It was not only the ABVP, it was also the students affiliated to left wing. Both the left wing and right wing students were involved in the entire violence. And second thing, there were outsiders who were called in by the intruders, and they were also involved in the attacks. Now, police is claiming that they have also verified the WhatsApp chats where the students, along with few other outsiders, were chatting, and they were asking which side they should come to the JNU campus. Now, that chat has been verified by the police, and police is claiming at this point of time is that they have called in the persons involved in the chats, and they will be questioned by the police, and then later they will be arrested if they will be fined behind the attacks. Now, apart from that, also the police at this point of time is claiming that they are going through the video footage, and after going through the video footage, they will make the arrest in this case. But what is important here is to point out that it has been more than 36 hours. Police is well aware of the identity of few of the students as well as the outsiders, but no arrests have been made. Also, the conduct of police is being questioned, because remember, on the day of incident, on January 5th, police got the first call at around 5 p.m. And 7:45, till 7:45, they waited for a written consent from the JNU administration, while in front of them, the students were being beaten up. They were stone pelting, and police was doing nothing, but they were mute spectators that day. So police is under heat at this point of time, but they are claiming that they are doing a thorough investigation, and crime branch is expected to make arrest in this case very soon. Back to you, Chaitanya.
Absolutely. Manish, continue to stay with us. Right there, we're getting breaking news coming in. Let's go straight across to it. The JNU violence and the videos on all of that material that is now being released by the ABVP, and the probe that is coming in from the Delhi police as well. Now, protesters gathered outside Mumbai's iconic Gateway of India in solidarity with the JNU students. They have been relocated to Azad Maidan in Mumbai. Police has asked the protesters to clear off this area, saying that it is causing problems to locals and tourists. Police also dragged some of the students who were reluctant to leave the protest site. Meanwhile, major row erupted after Free Kashmir poster was displayed at Mumbai protests on Monday by a woman protester. The protest, where the poster was displayed, saw the attendance of leading celebrities, including directors Vishal Bhardwaj, Zoya Akhtar, actors Swara Bhaskar, Diya Mirza and Tapsi Pannu. Former Maharashtra Chief Minister Devendra Fadnavis questioned Chief Minister Uddhav Thackeray, asking whether he is going to tolerate the anti-India campaign under his nose. Actor Anupam Kher also slammed the display of the poster. Congress leader Sanjay Nirupam urged Uddhav Thackeray government to probe the display of the poster.
जब भी हमें उठाने लगे, बिकॉज एक बार हमें उठाने की कोशिश की गई, हमने एक दूसरे को पकड़ लिया, और मेरी एक दोस्त है, उसे अपने बालों से खींचा गया. जब भी मुझे पांच छह जनों ने उठाने की कोशिश की, मैं बैग पकड़ के बैठ गई थी, मुझे नहीं उठा पाए वो लोग, तो मुझे उन्होंने लाठियां मारी, मुझे पैर पे मारा.
Actually,
गया
क्या हुआ था?
मारा गया.
Actually, क्या हुआ था?
बहुत लकी हूँ कि मुझे सर पे नहीं लगी है.
हम लोग को 100 से ज्यादा तादाद में पुलिस ने आके घेर लिया था, और हम लोग मुश्किल से 50 लोग भी नहीं थे, और वो कह रहे थे कि बात करेंगे, बट अचानक से सब लोग घेरने लग गए, और सब लोग उठाने, पैर हाथ से उठाने लग गए हम लोगों को.
हमने इनको टाइम टू टाइम अपील की थी, टाइम टू टाइम पीसफुल रहने के लिए कहा था, बट जब इनकी वजह से रोड्स ब्लॉक हो रहे, कॉमन मुंबईकर्स को तकलीफ हो रही है, लोगों के बाकी भी जो काम के एस्पेक्ट्स है उनको अफेक्ट हो रहा है, टूरिस्ट जो यहाँ रहे उनको अफेक्ट हो रहा है, तो देन वी अपील टू देम, वी अपील टू देम ट्वाइस थ्राइस मेनी टाइम्स, बट नाउ दे देमसेल्फ्स आर सेइंग दैट दे हैव सो मेनी ग्रुप्स दैट नोबडी इज लिसनिंग टू देम, सो इसीलिए फिर हमने उनको सिर्फ रीलोकेट किया है.
Let's also listen in to the girl holding the Free Kashmir poster and filmmaker Anurag Kashyap, what they think of the entire JNU violence.
I think it is all raising voice for humanity, and when it's talking about humanity, I feel we should talk about everything. That's about it.
Are you talking about internet shutdown or what are you?
I'm talking about basic humanity. As humans, we need freedom, and we have to talk for everyone. That's all.
वहाँ से बकायदा पूरी तरह 370 जाना चाहिए, इंटरनेट हटना चाहिए, जिस तरह से जो इंटेंशन है इनका, जिस इंटेंशन के साथ ये हर चीज़ कर रहे हैं. अभी जो डाटा प्रोटेक्शन एक्ट भी आने वाला है, उनके जो इंटेंशन वो साफ दिखती है, उनकी इंटेंशन साफ दिखती है. ये सिर्फ चुनाव की राजनीति करना चाहते हैं, ये सिर्फ इलेक्शन कंट्रोल करना चाहते हैं. इस पूरी सरकार का एक ही मकसद और एक ही मुद्दा है, ये ना तो हमारी इकोनॉमी ठीक कर पा रहे हैं, ना हम एजुकेशन दे सकते हैं. उनको पढ़े लिखों से डर लगता है, उनको जानकार लोगों से डर लगता है.
So those are the visuals that are coming in. The protests have moved to the financial capital in Mumbai as well. A large number of people did gather outside Gateway of India in protest, and they were moved to Azad Maidan too. They gathered outside Gateway of India in solidarity with the JNU students. They got relocated to Azad Maidan, and the police asked the protesters to clear off the Gateway of India, saying it's causing problems. Now, police also dragged some of the students who were reluctant to leave the protest site. So that's raising very big questions on the Mumbai police as well. Overall, looks like the protesters who were gathered outside Mumbai or any or in Delhi as well, there's a larger sense of disenfranchisement which is going on amidst the protesters, because it's not just the JNU incident. There are many other issues that are being flagged off in these particular protests, and not just the JNU.
Are you suggesting
after mass goons went on a rampage at the JNU that revealed injured several students and teachers, JNU alumnus and External Affairs Minister S. Jayashankar, while addressing a book launch session in the national capital, snubbed the Tukde Tukde gang over the violence at the university. S. Jayashankar, during the session, said that during his time at the JNU, there was no Tukde Tukde gang. The JNU alumni, soon after violence erupted at the university, condemning the incident, saying that violence goes against the culture and tradition of JNU.
On your JNU issue, I think what I had to say on JNU, I said yesterday, it was very clear, and I can certainly tell you, when I studied in JNU, it was not, we didn't see any Tukde Tukde gang.
Geeta Mohan joins us live. Geeta, the Minister of External Affairs, S. Jayashankar, is an alumnus of the JNU, as is Nirmala Sitharaman as well. While they've both gone ahead in condemning this particular incident that has taken place, it's been, they're obviously compelled to toe the line of the establishment in this case, Geeta.
Well, that's right. Again, the fact that Dr. Jayashankar and Nirmala Sitharaman were the first two cabinet ministers to really come out and condemn the violence in JNU. Yesterday, when specific question was asked with regards to the JNU violence, he just said that he's already said what he wanted to in the tweet that he'd put out, and has nothing more to add, but also said that in his time, there was no such thing as Tukde Tukde gang, which certainly has not gone down well with those today, currently, presently studying in Jawaharlal Nehru University. Many of them wanting to have the topmost leadership and political leadership of India come out and condemn the violence openly. But that certainly did not come their way from the alumnus Dr. S. Jayashankar.
Thanks for watching the video. For more such news and updates, please like, share and subscribe to India Today. Also check out our other great videos from our channel. We know you will love to.